Students, now we discuss about Bohr-Schwerin atomic structure of hydrogen atom. So here this is an electron and this is nucleus. Okay, so in hydrogen atom we know the atomic number of hydrogen is 1. So it has 1 proton inside the nucleus. Okay, so this is plus E. So the electron is revolving around the nucleus in that orbit. The electron is revolving around the nucleus in that orbit. Okay, so we know, so when the electrons is revolving around the nucleus in that orbit, then a force is required. Already we discussed in previous lecture, that is centripetal force. So the electrons revolving around the nucleus in a circular orbit of radius r with a definite force, that is a force is required, which is centripetal force. So that centripetal force is provided by the electrostatic force in between electron and this is nucleus. That is, this is nucleus and this is electron. Electron and nucleus. So the required centripetal force is provided by the electrostatic force in between them, in which the electrons is revolving around the nucleus with a definite velocity, that is V. Okay, so that centripetal force is provided by this. Suppose an electron of mass m is moving around the orbit, around the nucleus in a circular orbit of radius r, then the required centripetal force is provided by the electrostatic force in between nucleus and electrons like this. So this mv square by r equal to k q1 q2 by r square. This is Coulomb force, electrostatic force. The electrostatic force is k q1 q2 by r square, which provide the centripetal force. So k means Coulomb's constant, q1 is E, that is nucleus, charge of nucleus, q2 is charge of electron E divided by r square, then mv square equal to k e square by r. So this is equation number 1. Okay, so this is Coulomb's constant, which is k equal to, already we know this k equal to, this is 9 into 10 to the power 9 newton meter square per Coulomb square. Okay, in a sign. Okay, again from Bohr's postulate, from Bohr's quantization, we get mvr equal to n h by twice. From Bohr's postulate we get Bohr's constant quantization mvr, that means angular momentum. This is v, mvr equal to n h by twice pi. This is equation number 2. If you divide equation number 2, 1 divided by 2, then we get speed of electron 1 by 2, we get mv square divided by mvr equal to k e square by r divided by n h by 2 pi. Okay, so this mv square by r, mvr, vv cancel, we get v by r equal to 2 pi to upore beshi gol to 2 pi k square divided by nh into r. We get 2 pi k square divided by nh into r. So this r and r cancel, then we get v equal to 2 pi k square divided by nh. Here v equal to 2 pi k square by nh. So this is the expression. So this is the expression of, suppose this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. So this is the expression of speed of electron in nth Bohr's orbit. Expression of speed of electron in nth Bohr's orbit. So this v is equal to 2 pi k square by nh. Already we know in electrostatic, this k Coulomb's constant k, this is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Already ami paisu that Coulomb's constant to k will be given by, so k equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay, so this from this we get, if you substitute this value of k in this equation, we get k thai ami 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught put koilu. So 2 pi e square divided by 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into nx. Okay, so this 2 pi cancel, then we get e square divided by 2 epsilon naught nx. So this is the speed of electron in nth orbit in terms of permittivity, and this is in terms of Coulomb's constant. This is in terms of Coulomb's constant, and this is in terms of permittivity. Okay, so this is equation number 3. So from this equation 2 and 3, we get the speed of electron in nth orbit Vn is proportional to 1 by n. That means if the number of orbit is increased, then speed of electron is decreased. That means K, L, M, N. Okay, that means in first orbit, the speed of electron is maximum. And in last orbit, the speed of electron will be minimum. Okay, so from this we get, if you apply N equal to 1, if you apply N equal to 1, and others value, if you apply, then we get the speed of electron in the first orbit. Okay, so now we apply, now we substitute these values of the constant, then we get the equation number 3 and 2, the equation number 2 and 3, equation number 2 and 3 represents the speed of electron in nth Bohr's orbit. Speed of electron in nth Bohr's orbit. Okay, so these two equations are speed of electron is nth Bohr's orbit. Okay, if you substitute this value, then we get speed of electron in Bohr's orbit Vn equal to, in this equation, if you supply equation number 3, speed of electrons in Bohr's orbit from 3, from equation number 3, then we get, I mean, can you hide this already? Vn equal to 1.6, e value me palo, 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19 square. Next, twice n, permittivity value already pies, I mean, absolute permittivity, 8.854 into 10 to the minus 12 in hekam. And Planck's constant 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 34. Then we get, if you calculate this value by using calculator, then we get Vn equal to 2.2 into 10 to the power 6 divided by n. That means this is the variation for first orbit n equal to 1, then V equal to, for first orbit, 2.2 into 10 to the power 6, for second orbit n equal to 2, for infinite orbit it is infinity, then V equal to 0. Okay, so like this we get the speed of electron in different orbit. So next we discuss about the radius of the electron in Bohr's orbit. Okay, expression of radius of electron, okay, of the Bohr's orbit. See, so now in radius of nth Bohr's orbit, what happened? Substitute the value of V from 2. In equation number 2, we get V equal to 2 pi k e square divided by nx. That means V equal to, okay? V equal to 2 pi k e square by nx in equation number 2. If you substitute the value of V from 2 in the Bohr's quantum postulate, that means m here equal to nx by 2 pi. Hey, equation that I will put for you. Then I will put that because m here equal to nx by twice pi. So this is m. If V paisilu ki 2 pi k e square by nx into r equal to nx by twice pi. Ami kot put koilo Bohr's jitu postulate asile, according to Bohr's postulate, m here equal to nx by twice pi, hetu put koilo. Then we get r equal to, that means r nx square product, that means cross product, r equal to it n square a square, 2 pi online 4 pi square k e square into m, that means r equal to n square a square divided by 4 pi square k e square m. So this is the expression of radius of Bohr's orbit in terms of Coulomb's constant k. So here you see h constant 4 pi square, k, p square, m, all are constant. All are constant. That means r proportional to what? N square. Here, from this expression, we get r radius of horse rabbit is proportional to r proportional to n square. This is for two orbit, r proportional to n square. Okay, for two different orbit, we get for two different orbit. Having radius ready r1 and r2, we get what happen? R1 by r2 equal to n1 by n2 whole square. R is proportional to n square. Therefore, for two different orbit having radius r1 and r2, we get r1 by r2 equal from this equation. This is equation number suppose 4. Okay. So from equation 4 we get r1 by r2 equal to n1 by n2 whole square. So this is a simple form to calculate the radius of the orbit. Okay. So next, if you substitute the value of k 1 by 4 pi epsilon, then we get again another form. This r is equal to n square a square divided by this is 4 pi square into k. K means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 16 pi square epsilon naught square. Okay? Into e square n. 4 pi square. Okay? 4 pi square into k means k to square k to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Okay, so that means 4 pi cancel, then we get n square a square epsilon naught divided by 4 pi cancel, then we get pi e square into n. This is r equal to n square a square, r equal to n square a square epsilon naught to paregol epsilon naught divided by yathakile pi eta e square m. So this is the expression of radius of in terms of permittivity. Okay, so if you substitute this value, then we get, so this is the expression of radius, equation number 4 and equation number 5. 4 and 5 give the radius of the nth Bosch orbit, expression of radius of nth Bosch orbit. So if you substitute this value, then we get this is n square, h is Planck's constant, epsilon naught, pi, we get this 4. This we get 0.53 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. Okay, into n square. N square into this is, if you substitute this value, then we get n square into 0.53 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. That means we get this is n square into 0.53 angstrom. For first orbit, it will be 0.5 angstrom. For second orbit, it will be n equal to 2 square, 4 into 0.5. Then third orbit, n equal to 3 square, then 9 into 0.5. Okay? So this is the expression of radius of nth Bosch orbit. Okay? Next, we discuss about the energy of Bosch orbit. Next, we discuss energy of Bosch orbit. Energy means total energy. This is the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. Okay, so next you see. So now, expression of energy of Bosch orbit. So energy means the total energy, sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. We know. So the kinetic energy is half of mv square. Here you see this kinetic energy equal to half of mv square. Okay. So from equation number 1 we get mv square equal to k e square by r. From equation 1 k e square by r. Then kinetic energy equal to half of k e square by r. Okay. Next, potential energy. Already we know potential energy. Ami gravitation ot paisilu. The potential energy in gravitation, potential energy u equal to g capital M small m divided by r in gravitation. That is minus. In gravitation, the gravitational potential energy u equal to minus of g m m by r. So why this value is negative? Because the gravitational force is attractive in nature. Gravitational force is attractive in nature. So the gravitational potential energy u equal to u is negative. G is constant, m is mass of sun, so n small m with the mass of planet, and r with the radius in which planet is revolving around the sun. Okay, so u equal to minus of g m m by r. Okay, so here also in between electron and nucleus, this force is attractive. So potential energy u equal to, here we get k. In terms of g, we get k. In terms of, in presence of capital M, then we get q1. In the place of small m, we get q2 divided by r. So k, q1, q2 by r. This is also similar. Okay. So this u equal to, here also it is negative. Because the force between electron and nucleus is attractive. So potential energy is negative. So it is k. So charge of nucleus, this is E. Size of electron, this is small e. So this radius is r, so k e square by r. So this u equal to minus k e square by r. So this is potential energy, that means electrostatic potential energy, minus k e square by r. Next, therefore, total energy, which is sum of kinetic energy and potential energy. Therefore, kinetic energy equal to half of k e square by r, potential energy equal to minus of k e square by r, then we get sum, then we get n equal to minus of k e square by potential. So if you substitute the value of r from equation number 4, that means r equal to n square h square by 4 pi square kz k e square m. The value that I am here put koru, then what we get? R equal to r value n square h square by 4 pi k e square m. That means I think equation number 3 and 4. Okay, so from this we get. So what happened? So substitute value of r in equation, in this equation, r value ami yat put korile en equal to minus k e square by 2 r. R value ami already paisu in terms of k, n square h square divided by 4 pi square k e square m. Already ami paisu equation number was only 3. Equation number 3 paisu r equal to n square h square by 4 pi square k e square m. Okay. So From this, if cut kora hol, en equal to minus 2 pi square k square e to the power 4 m divided by n square a square. So this is the expression of energy of nth orbit. This is en equal to minus of 2 pi square k square e to the power 4 m divided by n square a square. Ami agor question to given paisilo. First will be equation number 5, so it will be equation number 6. Equation number 6, okay? Minus of 2 pi square, k square, e to the power 4 m. I mean, n square, a square, okay? Ako dhari ami value put koru. K value dhari put koi lu. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught put koi lu. Minus 2 pi square, e to the power 4 m divided by n square a square k square is equal to 1 by k square means 4 pi epsilon naught square, that means 4 pi epsilon naught, 4 square 16 pi square epsilon naught square, that means 16 pi square epsilon naught square. Then we get this pi square cancel, 2 and 16 it will be cancelled, then we get m e to the power 4 divided by 8 pi square cancel, epsilon naught square a square n square en equal to m e to the power 4 8 epsilon naught square n square a square. So for first orbit n equal to 1, then we get m e to the power 4 divided by 8 epsilon naught square a square. Okay, so this is most important. So in this part, every values will be important. A part of particular value will be able to pare. Radius will be able to pare. Energy will be able to pare. But velocity will be able to pare. Belag belag expression. If you substitute the value of the constant in this expression, then we get the energy, that is ground state energy of electron in Bohr, that is Bohr's ground state energy. Okay, so next we get Bohr's ground state energy. Next, Bohr's. So what will be the value? Okay, then Bohr's ground state energy. So ground state energy of Bohr's orbit. So if you substitute this value, En equal to minus m means mass of electron, so 9.1 into 10 to the power minus 31 mass of electron into e to the power 4, 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, 4, then 8 epsilon naught 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 whole square a square 6.6 into 10 to the power minus 34 square bohai disu into n square n square. Then we get, this will be, after calculation we get, this will be 21.76 into 10 to the power minus 19 divided by n square joule en equal to minus 21.76 into 10 to the minus 10 to the minus 19 divided by n square joule. So it will be minus 21.76 into 10 to the power minus 19 divided by 13.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 n squared, and it will convert into electron volt. So 1 electron volt equal to 1.6 into 10 to the minus 19. Then we get minus 13.6 by n squared en equal to electron volt. So this is the variation of energy of the electron in different orbit. So En equal to minus 13.6 divided by n squared electron volt. So for first orbit, we get energy of different orbit. Different orbit, that means Bohr's different orbit. First, number 1, minus 13.6 electron volt, En equal to 1. Next, n equal to 2 square. Minus 3.4 electron volt. Next, third, minus 13.6 divided by 3 square, minus 1.51 electron volt. Next, 4, 13.6 divided by 4 square, minus 0.85 electron volt. 5, 13.6 divided by 5 square minus 0.54. E5 like this, E6 36, then it will be minus 0.38 electron volt. E7 minus 13.6 by 7 square, it will be minus 0.28 electron volt. So these are the energy of different Bohr's orbit. Okay, so after this, so these are today we discuss about Bohr's theory in atomic structure, how we determine velocity of nth orbit, radius of nth orbit. So velocity is inversely proportional to number of orbit, radius is inversely proportional to n square, and E is proportional to minus of n square. That means if n is increased, then n is increased, number of orbit is increased, then negative value of E is decreased. That means energy is increased. Okay, that means energy E proportional to minus 1 by n squared. If n is increased, then negative value is decreased. That means the value of energy is increased. That means due to increasing number of orbit, the energy is, total energy of the Bohr's orbit is increased. Okay, so next we discuss about Rydberg constant. How Rydberg constant is to be calculated in spectral series. Okay, so today's class is over. Thank you.